Welcome to the show. This is the show where we watch weird, dumb, funny, the best, the worst, the greatest, the dumbest of all time Saturday morning cartoons from the golden age of Saturday morning. This is the show, and I'm Joe, and that's Nick, and that's George, and that's Caitlin. And today, here's what we're going to do. We're going to do something different. We're not going to watch a cartoon yet. We're still early on in the season. I had this idea a while ago where we just watched the opening themes to cartoons. We have this long list of all the themes or of all of cartoons that we want to watch. And this morning, we're just going to watch the theme songs. What do you guys think about that?
Sounds great.
Let's do it.
I think it's like judging a book by its cover. I think you can generally tell by the opening theme if you're in for something good, if it's worth watching the whole episode or not.
Well, and not only that we can decide whether we want to watch the cartoon in the future, but also we can deconstruct these opening songs a little bit, and like the wordplay and the lyrics and they're pretty bad. They're usually pretty bad, and they're usually pretty long. So this will give us an opportunity to really dive into that. So let's kick off with a commercial first. This is a pretty musical episode, so I thought I'd kick off with, like, I don't know, a musical toy commercial, one that was always kind of in my head at all times. And I think it could also be a George's deathbed vision. It's Baby Alive. Are you familiar with Baby Alive?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, here we go. Baby Alive.
It's my favorite juice and kiss cookies, album. Baby Alive. Sipping from your juice box just for me. You're as real as can be. Juice and cookies, Baby Alive. It's fun making snacks just for you. You need your bib. Take a bite of your cookie. Drink your juice, too. Changing your diaper when you're through. She really chews. Juice and cookies, Baby Alive. I love the way you make me feel. You're so real. New Juice and Cookies, Baby Alive comes with their own juice box and everything you see here. Each sold separately. Batteries not included.
So there we go. Yeah.
Eating the that baby reminds me. Green cookies.
So yeah, gross. I know. And just the way I was eating it, too. Just...
And a wedge of Swiss cheese, just like babies eat. But it reminds me of the snack time kids, the Cabbage Patch kids that you could put in plastic food and their jaws would do the chewing mechanism. Ooh. But then it was recalled because it didn't have an off switch or a kill switch for the chewing mechanism. So
it killed several kids, right?
Well,
several
kids
were killed. No, I think it ripped
out. Scalped. I think they were scalped.
It ripped out their hair. Yeah.
Yeah. And, so I went to the Cabbage Patch Museum in Iowa, this woman, Donna's Cabbage Patch Fantasyland, and she has all these recalled snack time kids that she's found at thrift stores. And she told me she's removed so much little girl hair out of the gears and mechanisms out of those.
Make an old museum of those.
Yeah, a little girl's hair.
Yeah. So anyway, Baby Alive seemed to might have had similar problems.
When I watched Baby Alive, like, eating the food, like, she just kind of like stares straight ahead with like a dead-eyed stare and just like kind of open. It's kind of how I eat food. I think it's kind of like joyless.
A cow chewing.
You just put it in the mouth and I just chew and then I just swallow it and then I just like digest it and then shit it out later.
You eat faster than
someone
alive.
Changes your diaper.
Somebody changes my diaper. They feed me a green cookie and
it's Joey Alive.
Hey, what? So I got it. Let's talk about our mugs. Let's talk about our cereals. For me, somebody sent this in. I love when people send me in mugs. Send me in mugs. I like to collect them because I'm always going to use them. You know what I mean? Like, They're always good.
I know what you mean.
So I don't know who sent this. It showed up on my desk. It's a cow saying, "Oh my God." So
love it.
But look at the cow's right. arm too. Do you see the cow's arm?
Is that an arm?
What is it that's coming off of
it? It's kind of going like this. It's kind of pointing to the "Oh my God" or giving a thumbs up.
I don't know.
I think he's got a shiv.
Is it not a cow though? Like, look at the snout is like a smiley face.
It's a cow. I just don't know if that's an arm, but I'm not sure what to think of this.
I think it's a cow giving a thumbs up.
I turned it upside down because it looks like one of those things where like you could turn it upside down and it could be something else, doesn't it? But it's not that. Hmm. It's just a cow saying, "Oh my God," with his arm. That's like I don't get it. Whoever sent me this, thank you very much for this weird mug. Yeah.
Caitlin, what do you have?
I have a Peanuts mug. I don't know why I'm laughing.
Talking about it last week. We were talking about it last week.
Yeah. And also, and I meant to say last week, but I'll say this week that as a little plug, we have a Peanuts exhibit up right now at the Billy Ireland Cartoon Library Museum because this year is Charles Schulz's 100th birthday. And
no
so
way.
You can come see Celebrating Sparky, Charles M. Schulz and Peanuts at the Billy Ireland. It'll be up through late October.
Oh, that's awesome. I want to see that. I'm a huge
Peanuts
fan. Huge Peanuts fan.
I know.
Yeah.
Well, when is it up to? End of October?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. We'll have to get there before then. George, what do you have?
Well, I decided to raid my big collection of Batman memorabilia to give you not just the Michael Keaton mug, but the Val Kilmer mug version.
Oh man!
So you can pick the Batman of your choice.
Wait, I gotta see these better, okay? Because you keep disappearing.
Well, one rubber and one ceramic.
That is correct.
Wow.
That means you get to win one of them.
Oh.
Yes. So the Kilmer, yeah, there.
Oh, nice.
Keaton, here.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. I can tell. You should have made us guess. That could have been a game.
Which one's the Kilmer?
Which one's the Keaton?
I don't actually use them because they need to be mint in their original box so that one day whoever finds my body can throw these in the dumpster.
or eBay them.
I want to go to, I'll be at that estate sale, George.
And I'm going to eBay them for $17. Cha-ching.
I went with a cereal because well, one, I'm running out of cool mugs, but I saw this on the shelf and I couldn't not try it because I think we're going to get a potential gag here. Ugh. This is a limited edition Cinefuego Toast Crunch. This is spicy cinnamon toast crunch. I just opened the package, but I haven't tried it yet. So I'm going to be a guinea pig here and try out Cinefuego Toast Crunch.
First of all, what the hell? Is that a box or is that like a plastic?
It's a bag. It's a bag,
a bag.
For snacking because I guess you know, with milk, it might be even grosser. So it smells like atomic fireballs. It smells like, or Red Hots. It doesn't smell like Cinnamon Toast Crunch. So let me just try some of this.
Okay.
I'll do a big mouthful.
Get a bunch.
You're looking for?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Well, I can't imagine it's going to be that spicy, right?
Fuego?
Yeah.
No.
What's the fuego level?
Muy fuego.
How many Scoville units?
It's going up my nostrils. It's going up my nostrils.
Really? Should we use this for punishments?
Oh my God. Yeah, when you swallow it, it burns going down.
Mm.
You paid for it.
It's like an atomic fireball. Oh my God. I can't believe how spicy it is.
Yeah, in a good way or in a bad way? Would you eat more?
It's like eating a bowl of cinnamon Red Hots, which could be good or bad, depending on whether you like them. But it's sticking with me. Like it still burns going down. So
you need some milk.
I don't recommend it, but for the novelty factor, it's pretty good. I'll try it with milk.
And you can't recommend it because they didn't pay us anything. So don't recommend it at all. Like unless they, you know what I mean?
I like giving people honest cereal recommendations, cheers or jeers, like the TV Guide column. And this one so far is a jeer for me.
Okay. So here's what I did. You ready to move on? You ready to move any? Okay, here we go. So here's what I did. I picked 10 themes 10 theme songs ranging from 30 seconds to like a minute and a half. Some of them go on for a minute and a half. I'm just going to play them and I'm going to talk about them in between each one. And let's jump in, huh? How's that sound?
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. I have a theory as to why they're so long, but we can talk about that at intermission.
Talk about it now.
Well, I think we've discussed this before, but everything in Saturday morning animation was about being cheap. So yeah. I think just by having an intro that's long, you're recycling that animation. It's like another minute and a half you don't have to animate every
for
week.
Sure.
New animation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like The Simpsons had a long intro because of that. And then when they were overstuffed, they would go with a shorter one. But, you know, then they would have the extra long intro when they were, you know, short on animation.
And as a viewer, I didn't mind that. I kind of like the preamble, the getting excited for the thing. It's just like, oh, I know the song and I like the whole thing. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But yeah, it's definitely like a cost cutting measure. So, all right, here we go. The very first one you're going to see is Teddy Ruxpin. We're going to start strong here. The theme song for Teddy Ruxpin, it's very maudlin and it sounds like, do you remember Fifth Dimension, up and away?
Yeah.
And my beautiful balloon. It's kind of like that. So, kicking things off here with Teddy Ruxpin, opening themes, Shaturday morning cartoons coming at you. Well, I should also tell you, I'm going to back it up. Pay close attention to the lyrics, because at the end, my game show is going to be all about the lyrics of these songs, because the lyrics are so good. So pay close attention, because that's what the game show is going to be. Here we go.
Okay.
Let's start over.
Ever have a bully in class give you a grundo? You know, where they pull your underwear.
Somebody's nickname on the show has to be Grundo. I'm Joe. That's Nick. That's Grundo. That's Caitlin.
I'm nominating George. Because of the G. Come dream with me tonight. Let's go to far off places and search for treasures bright. Come dream with me tonight. Let's build a giant airship and sail into the sky. Let's watch the ground so far below. Let's watch the birds as they fly by. Fly so high. That's powerful as hell, isn't it? That's powerful.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that sounded like the voice of Teddy Ruxpin singing it too, which, you know, the cartoons normally didn't sing their own theme songs.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. I guess I didn't know what Teddy Ruxpin sounded like. But
yeah, that's what he sounds like. He's inviting you to dream with him. It makes sense. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah. All right. What do you think? Would you want to watch more episodes of the show at some point?
Yes.
Okay.
Well,
it's kind of lame, to be honest. It seems super lame.
Yeah, Nick, he got outvoted on that one. Nick with an instant
Nick was
yes.
So excited.
Well, Grundo, you win. What do you think?
Grundo, what do you think?
The reason I would say yes is because I would love to do a history of the toy Teddy Ruxpin and the DeVry commercial that had Teddy Ruxpin in it and, you know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But the cartoon probably is nothing to write home about.
Who does the Teddy? I assume this is the guy who made Teddy Ruxpin. Oh, is it maybe a Pinocchio kind of thing? Because he kind of looks like what's Pinocchio's dad's? Geppetto. He's Geppetto.
That's an elderly Luigi, I think.
Yeah. That's Luigi all grown up.
Didn't Katie Lee say that it was like a friend of hers who did the voice, or either the voice or created Teddy Ruxpin on that episode?
Yes,
that we did with her.
It was her on for Richie Rich, right?
And right, but she talked about. Yeah.
So get that friend, and then I don't have to watch Teddy Ruxpin.
You're sick that week.
All right, next up we got Mad Balls. You guys have Mad Balls? You remember Mad Balls?
Sure.
I loved Mad Balls. Yeah, we had them too. American Greetings put this toy out. You know, like
they I were. I didn't think they went into the gross territory.
I didn't either, surprised. But they were just like, yeah. I wonder if like. I just like, wouldn't that be fun to work for American Greetings like back in like the 80s? And they're like, hey, we're going to open up a gross division. We're going to bring you
Joe,
on.
You're our filth man.
You're our filth man. Can you imagine? That would be a dream job. You're working for American Greetings. We need something filthy but accessible. Well, they came up with Mad Balls. And this is a direct-to-video cartoon that did 6 episodes of it. And this is a mercifully short intro song. And it's a cover song. So, and it must have been public domain at this point because they don't change the lyrics that much. All right, here it is, Mad Balls intro theme. They could have said like Mad Balls on Fire. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like they could have changed it. They could have Weird Al'd it a little bit.
And just to recap, Too Much Love drives a ball insane.
I can verify that.
Oh, is that what she said?
Too much love drives a ball insane. Okay. You broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness of grace is great balls of fire.
Okay. Did everybody have Mad Balls here?
Yes.
I would assume. You did?
It was a comic book, too. I had the one-eyed one, I remember specifically. And wasn't there one that
looked
like a baseball?
Oculus
Orcus? Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, George, that's a deep pull. Oculus Orcus.
I think that's it.
Wow. American Greetings.
I think. I don't know. I can't remember.
Yeah, exactly. It sounds right.
And I had this one, too, that looks like a baseball, right?
I had the baseball one. Yeah. That's the one that I had. But American Greetings. Oh, really?
No, we wanted them. Never had them. Mm-hmm. I wanted Boglins. I wanted these, but
Boglins, too.
Your family wouldn't allow them? Were they,
that's where they drew the line.
Did you have a family meeting and they were like, Nick, we talked it over and no, yep. We're not going to get you Mad Balls for Christmas this year.
Yeah, it was our Saturday morning war room, like Dr. Strange. Parents came in and said, no Mad Balls. Sorry.
Request denied.
We have a VHS tape though called Mad Balls Gross Jokes, and it's got I think two Mad Balls cartoons. So I would like to watch this one, and also it's season 3. We gotta take what we can get at this point.
Well, yeah. Well, and also yeah, this is not. They don't do Shaturday. They don't do Saturday morning cartoons like they're direct to video. So it might be interesting to see, like, you know, maybe they can get away with more, you know. They're not beholden to somebody. American Greetings, a well-oiled machine, right? I mean, like, they, tip my hat.
Joe, I think your tagline, by the way, you mentioned that American Greetings was going for this, but I think filthy but accessible should be sort of your selling point as a host for all of our VCR party-related content.
Or maybe on my business cards that I hand out to people at networking events.
Filthy but accessible. Nice to meet you.
What, I'm at the conventions in Las Vegas? They're like, hey, how you doing? Yeah. Nice to meet you. All right, next up, Nick, I did this one for you specifically. I'm sure you've seen it before, but it's Alf the Animated Series. Mm-hmm. This has one of the longer intros. This is a full minute and a half. And this show had 2 seasons, 26 episodes. It's the longest intro of all time. Are you familiar with it at all? Have you guys watched it on Willie's Garage?
No, we've talked about it, and we've had... that one of the writers of it on the show. So
I watched Alf Tales, right? Or the
Alf Tales, which is the follow up to this. Yeah.
Is the follow up to the animated series?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Here it is. Alf, the animated series. Oh, Gordon. I already see like 5 places where they could edit this to make it shorter. Right, like there's
Nick
nothing
doesn't.
Has happened yet. Gordon, send us into outer space, 'cause there ain't no one like you in the Melmacian race. Who's who's Gordon?
That's Gordon Alf. Shumway. That's Alf.
Oh, that's Alf.
His name's Gordon Shumway, but when he lands on Earth, they call him an alien life form. So,
okay, all right. So, sorry, Gordon. Nick, for Gordon launched us into outer space. Okay, so.
You're the only one that can scratch our ears. So Gordon, Gordon, put us in stitches. There ain't no one like you in this place. Melmac is not the worst that. Melmac is really no place for cats. But Gordon, you got an angle on things. You're the only one here who sings and swings.
Gordon, send us in the house, baby.
Cause there ain't no one like you.
See, they didn't need this verse. They didn't need this one. They could have just ended it there. Alpha series. They're repeating themselves at this point.
Yep. Second verse.
Yeah. Caitlin, where do you stand on Alf? You were probably like -4 when this came out, right?
It was a little slightly before my time, but yeah. I appreciate it. Yeah. I like it a lot.
Okay.
I mean, not Nick level. I'm not, you know.
Nobody does.
Making a lifestyle of
not
it.
Not even but, Alf yeah. does. Not even Gordon Shumway does.
Yeah.
More tabby paw pie for me before bedtime.
And every episode started with that too. He said that every single time. From what I've seen.
Yeah. Can I give
what is happening here? Ooh, let's move off this frame.
I know.
Can I give a deep dive? Well, not a deep dive, but a fun fact about this intro. Can you stop sharing for a sec, Joe?
Sure.
So here we go.
Everybody buckle up.
In the first episode of Elf the Animated Series, this is the intro as it aired. Listen.
Gordon, send us into outer space.
Cause there ain't nobody like you in the Malmaison race.
Teach us, send us, Gordon, make us twitch.
You're the only one that can scratch our wrists. So Gordon.
So they were reading, I think when they gave the theme song to the singers, they spelled out Melmacian, but they didn't know it. So when you see the spelling of Melmacian, you could think it's Melmashian.
Like Appalachian.
Like Appalachian. Melmashian. Wow. And so they didn't catch it. So in the first episode, it's Melmashian. And then this is episode 2.
Gordon Sanders in the outer space.
Cause there ain't no one like you in the Melmacian race.
So, can you imagine they had to book that time at the studio again? Bring everybody back
like,
in.
All right, we'll go back in Mackian. And say Melmacian. We'll add another syllable in there.
But it also sounds like there's like 5 or 6 singers on this too. Mm-hmm. Like they have to bring them all back in. And like, don't you guys watch the show? It's Melmacian.
Clearly not.
No. Oh boy. And also I loved how quickly you had that clip accessible. Like you were just like, oh, hold on, I got the clip right here. I got the hard drive hooked up and let me just
there
play
was
that.
No
right.
post-production on that. I had that fairly
there's no,
handy.
There's no editing on that at all. All right, moving on. So I didn't even know this existed. I don't know if somebody told us about this or what, but Back to the Future had a cartoon. And what a great idea for a cartoon. But we see a lot of time traveling in these cartoons, like Fonzie and the gang and the Partridge Family. And they, you know, they always do all the same things. It's always going to Egypt and they always go to, you know.
Dinosaur times.
Dinosaurs and yeah. But I haven't actually watched one of these, but I'm sure they have an Egypt episode. I'm sure they have all the episodes. But Back to the Future, here it is. And you'll recognize this song here, but you won't recognize the person who's singing it. So here it is, Back to the Future.
And of course, there's a funny dog sidekick.
Right. Of course. Yeah. But I don't know if he can talk or not. I haven't watched any episodes. I would really like to watch one of these episodes. I'm going to put this on the docket. I think that we should watch a Back to the Future this season. I think
we have it on VHS. We have at least one episode.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's add that. All right. The last one before we get to a commercial break is Cops from 1988. Deke did this one. And I looked it up. I don't know if it came out right after Cops, the reality show, came out, if they were parlaying that, but like it has nothing to do with Cops, the reality show, but it came out around the same time. So I don't know. But yeah, take a look. It actually looks pretty, like, it looks, the music's awesome and like the animation is pretty good. It's action packed. Here we go, Cops.
Cops, central organization of police specialists fighting crime in a future time, protecting Empire City from Big Boss and his gang of crooks.
I mean, look at this. It's pretty good. Hell of an intro.
Wow.
It's crime fighting time. Wow.
It's crime fighting time. I mean, it could be one of those ones where like we watch it and it's just like, oh, this is too well produced. I mean, maybe we should skip that one and just watch it in our private time.
I disagree. There's a somebody told me about an episode of this where there's a villain called Addictum. And he's trying to push a drug called Crystal Twist.
Yeah, oh, we have to watch this.
Oh, okay. All right, never mind.
Let's watch it on mushrooms.
Let's watch Crystal Twist.
There was a drug episode of Gem that we watched that was a classic. So I think that could be a classic.
Drug episodes are always fun. Mm-hmm. So, all right, let's do that. George, what do you got for commercials today?
All right, so we're in, mid-September? And I think there were still commercials being run when we were kids that had back to school themes, although we were already back in school, but they'd been running since August. And yeah. I'll never forget 1988, late summer, I got the flu and I was sitting on the couch and I was so mad about losing summertime and this commercial came on.
September means, so head for Roy Rogers now and get a juicy bacon cheeseburger or a great tasting regular roast beef sandwich plus medium fries and a 15-ounce tray for $2.99. But hurry, time's running out.
See you soon.
This is the most depressing commercial of my life. But
those real lunch ladies?
Yeah, I don't know. But anyhow, so the theme of commercials today are back to school. Shaturday morning cartoons will be right back.
That's all you're taking to class?
Everything I need's in my new Trapper portfolio.
Trapper?
Traps in all my papers. The pocket's this way, so I close the Trapper, the papers stay trapped in. One Trapper freed subject.
Where do you keep them?
In the Trapper Keeper, which also has a notepad and pencil clip. After school, snap it shut, take everything home. What could be neater?
A date with her.
Trapper and Trapper Keeper, only from Mead.
Oh, that's free. Free Lisa Frank art. Back
to school. Buy three pair of Wrangler jeans and Wrangler will send you coupons worth $6. Four pair.
This is what the 80s were like.
Five pair coupons worth $20. Buy all cords and get an extra $10 in coupons from Wrangler. And Hills has one of the biggest selections you'll find anywhere. Quality and low price. Get it together at Hills.
We got it together.
Wrangler jeans.
So get it together at Hills.
Quality and low prices every day. No need to wait for a sale ever.
You guys ever own Wranglers?
No. Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think I own one pair of Wranglers.
I was never a jeans wearer, so.
Oh.
Yeah. Still have never worn jeans.
Wow.
Even to this day?
No.
What do you wear? Like slacks or something?
Always been a slack man. Yeah. And occasionally I wore corduroys, but never jeans.
Oh, slack man. That might be a new Nick song. Slack man. Oh.
Nick slacks.
Slack okay. man. Yeah. Well, yeah. No, there's something
he's
there.
The slack man.
There's something there. There's something with slack man.
You've got to get him to put on jeans on one episode of VCR Party.
Wranglers.
Yeah. No, let's do it for the Patreon. Butt. We'll be like, once we get up to like
$6,000. Yeah.
It'll be a cold day in hell, Grundo.
I'm driving around with a Wet Pets license plate. You won't put on jeans. Thanks.
The animals are coming. We're all brand new. Mead makes a Critter Sitter just for you. Critter Sitter animals, any old size. Bought a whole new bunch of school supplies.
There's a beaver.
And a beagle.
And a baby bear.
A bunny.
And a kitten.
All sitting right there.
We should sing this on some
episode. And notebooks too. Psychology class with a private.
You're the Critter Sitters.
We may not help your grades,
but we'll sure raise your spirits.
Look for the Critter Sitters only from Mead.
Hey everybody, have you heard the
Look
news?
That
there's a back-to-school sale at Payless for you. Yeah, they got what you need when the summer ends. Like pencils and notebooks, crayons and pens. Watercolors, cooking, tube socks and shoes. Scissors and erasers, anything you choose. Lunchboxes, pencil boxes, notebook paper, glue, typewriters, calculators, tape recorders too. Even got a scooter,
gotta get the best.
You gotta get more, but you're gonna pay less.
So what's the best part
about back-to-school? It's a back-to-school sale at Payless.
Oh, God.
You know, I'm kind of looking forward to going back to school, and I can imagine you're a little excited yourself, especially since you'll be saving all that money on back-to-school supplies from Southern Stationers. Let's see. There's binders, notebooks, geometry sets, calculators, drafting supplies, and more. I figure with all that money you'll be saving on school supplies from Southern Stationers could pay for my college education at one of the top surfing schools in Hawaii. I'm sure you're looking forward to going back to school.
Now back to Shaturday morning cartoons.
Oh, wow. I hope that kid can be himself and is loved and embraced right now.
But also, when you started seeing the commercials for back to school, you start seeing the signs up on the, you know, the store walls and stuff, you'd be like, oh, fuck.
Yes, I
hate the school.
I still feel like physically ill when I see the signs in Target.
I do too. I can't stand it. Yeah. And I have nothing to do with school, not even close, but I still feel that kind of gut pain.
Totally.
And then that kid walks in and he's just like, back to school. It's like, shut up. You sell out. You sell out to all of us.
What? What's worse is by August, you have no aim. You've run out of things to do. Yeah. You're sitting around the house. You know you have to go back. And you know you also can't think of anything better. And it's a horrible, horrible feeling.
It's the worst.
And I've been there ever since 1997. That's been...
And your next
I do want that beaver folder, though. A little bit. I want that a little bit.
All right. Yeah. All right. Second half. Here we go. More themes. Let's get into Double Dragon. Another Deke. It's a video game. We have some video game people who, Mike Drucker comes on the show occasionally, and he appreciates video games. So maybe we could have him on for
Bob
this one.
Mackey.
Yeah, I played Double Dragon recently with my niece and nephew on my Nintendo system when they came to visit last summer. And it's really violent. Like, it's like, they're like punching women in the stomach and it's just like they're playing it. It's just like, oh, wait a second. This is like, yeah. Anyway, here's Double Dragon by Deke.
To be a dragon, you gotta be strong. Humble, never bragging. Always fight for right.
They rhyme. Wait, to be a dragon, you've got to be strong. They're always humble, not bragging. So they're rhyming dragon with bragging.
Nick, I'm glad you picked up on that because that might be a question coming up. All right.
Always fight for right, battle then wrong with the power of the dragon. Never call the call of the dragon. Fight for right, the might of the dragon. With the mark of the dragon.
Never call the call of the dragon. No
never intentionally harm another. Do not battle if you can avoid it. Jimmy and Billy Lee are Dragon Masters now.
Dragon Master was born with the mark of the double dragon.
Still going.
Yeah, it's one of those never enders. Yeah, it just keeps on going and going and going. So I think that could be a fun one, although I see where this is going. You know, we've seen this one a million times. I think we can skip that one.
Good selection of the theme songs, though. These have all been killer.
Yeah.
The lyrics, just pay close attention to the lyrics. They're okay. So good. All right, next up, another movie. This is another movie. A rated R movie cartoon spinoff. You know, we've had Rambo in the past where it was like a rated R movie, but somehow they got a cartoon made.
RoboCop, yeah.
Yep, this is Police Academy. The first one was rated R, I think mainly for nudity reasons, and probably some swearing, but see if you can name the group who raps the intro.
Bat Boys?
Huh? Bat Boys? Yep. Wow. Good.
Nice.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. That was a. Yeah. What was her book? Can you see what her book says? 1001 Uzi Ways.
Cat Burglar.
Uzi Ways to Kill a Cat Burglar.
Easy, but maybe.
No, it's Uzi. Uzi.
I think it's a play on Easy. Yeah.
Oh, Uzi Ways to Catch a Cat Burglar?
Okay.
Wow. Okay. Yeah. Joke on top of a joke.
They're tested, tried and true. They keep the peace
for you and me.
Hooray, the Police Academy.
I think that's supposed to be Zed right there. Mm. I think it's Bobcat Goldthwait.
A close
I think
personal
so.
Friend, Bobcat Goldthwait.
Yeah. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. But wait. That wasn't their relationship. He wasn't like playing pranks on him, right? Proctor
Mahoney.
Oh, that's Mahoney. I thought that was
Mahoney.
Proctor.
Yeah,
okay.
That's Gutenberg. Yeah.
Oh, I see. Never mind. So sorry. Glad to have you here, Nick. Thank you.
Yeah, he would always play pranks on Harris.
I thought that was Proctor.
Hey, somebody forgot to dot the I.
I'll fix it.
Police Academy, the series.
Hooray!
Okay.
Wow.
Comedies are tough.
The thing I like about it is just my favorite part about Police Academy, the animated series, is that Michael Winslow playing Jones, the fun part was like he could do like a helicopter noise or a siren in the movies,
right,
with his mouth. So like he'd be over the PA and they'd be like, oh no, a helicopter's shooting us. In the series, they just dub over real helicopter sounds while he makes mouth flapping sounds, which kind of defeats the impressive right. part about being able to do the
it's probably
sound,
not even so. Michael Winslow who's the voice of him. They probably no. couldn't afford Michael Winslow to be in that.
Right.
So yeah. No, and then they just put in some sound effects and it was like, oh wow, that's impressive. Yeah.
I'm
all right.
curious, Caitlin, since that was before your time, did that cross over to a later generation?
I saw the movies when I was a kid, but I have not seen them as an adult. And so I don't have like a strong attachment to it. But
what was the context of you seeing them as a kid? Was it like on HBO in the afternoon? You just like turned it on and like you watched it, or did your family
didn't have
watch
HBO,
it?
HBO, but I think my parents either rented it or it was on TV or something. So yeah,
I feel like probably by the time you were born, it was probably Mission to Moscow time. I don't know. I'm just trying to do the math in my head. But
I was
think,
born in 86.
Okay. Okay, so by the time you were like an actual human, it was probably Mission to Moscow time, right?
Could have been.
Nick, what year was Mission to Moscow? You're the resident police academy.
I do have them all on Blu-ray. Mission to Moscow, police academy. I want to say that was probably 89. Okay. No, 94. That was later than I thought.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah. I thought that would be more in Caitlin's wheelhouse.
For some reason, the only thing I remember about the Police Academy movies was that there's some scene where a woman is wearing high heels or someone's wearing high heels and there's a goldfish in it. Does this mean anything to anybody?
Yeah.
And that like stuck in my brain as a child and I thought it was so cool.
Because
so.
Commandant Lassard had his precious goldfish that he loved. So, yeah.
Okay.
Would it be all in right. somebody's shoe? I don't know. Yeah. That's all I remember.
I mean, that could have been a weird dream you had too. So.
That's true. Yeah.
All right. Next up, My Pet Monster, which it was a little bit after my time, but I think this is another American Greetings.
Yes. Production. And it's within my wheelhouse.
Yes, exactly. So My Pet Monster. And of course, they came out with a cartoon. So here we go.
He's just having lots of fun in his own monster way. He loves to munch on garbage. He'll even eat the can. If this sounds gross, please understand. He's my best friend. My pet monster. Very, very bestest friend. My pet monster. A monster of a friend. A monster of a friend.
Monster. Hmm. All right, it has
a feeling of like a major network attempt at Ren and Stimpy or something, right? I mean, like the backgrounds are all like 50s or 60s and like, I don't know. I mean, the animation style is much cheaper. So that's why I know it's a network as opposed to.
It's probably from American Greetings, like their filth department was like, let's do like our version of Ren and Stimpy, but let's not go too far. Like, right. Let's not. Yeah.
I think their filth department was probably described as their boy skewing,
right,
department.
Right.
So gross things, monsters.
Yeah.
What, Caitlin? Sorry.
I was just going to say it tells you nothing, though. You know, like some of the theme songs have like a ton of exposition. Like I will never forget the MC Hammer cartoon theme song, which I think was the best one. It tells you the entire plot of this. Whereas this, all we know is that a pet monster and he's his best friend. Like what else is happening in this show?
That's what more do you need to get on board? Come on.
This is a great lesson in what not to do. Because like, yeah, where did he come
no
from?
Other characters. Yeah.
Did he come from like a spaceship? From like another planet, like what, like where did my pet monster? Yeah, did somebody like say some like lyrics of something that like made him come up from the ground? We don't know. We have no idea where he even came from, and that's why they only had probably 58 episodes of the show. So
I'd still watch it.
Yeah, I would still watch it.
We have the live action My Pet Monster kids movie on VHS, where it's a horrifying, like
I didn't know there was one
costume. And I believe the backstory for that is that he's a museum thing that comes to life, like in a wing of a museum. He comes to life, but I don't know if that's the cartoon backstory.
Okay. Did you have a My Pet Monster, Caitlin?
Yes, I did.
You actually did?
Okay. I did have one. I loved it. Yeah.
All right. Next up, Bigfoot.
It's like my first S&M toy. It's got handcuffs. And...
It does.
Oh yeah, it does. Bigfoot, this is one I'm already gonna say, like this is Bigfoot the monster truck got its own cartoon, and I'm just gonna say we gotta watch this already just based on the theme song alone. So here's Bigfoot.
Here comes Bigfoot to show off the stuff, the best of the big ones. He's rough and he's tough.
Bigfoot and the muscle machines,
they're big,
man, dirty and mean.
Call on Bigfoot if you get in a fight. He'll come to the rescue.
Can I just watch this a bunch of times today? So they're jumping over everything like they do in those monster truck rallies, right?
Yep.
And so they had what they thought was like something they could land on,
A landing carpet.
Yeah, a landing carpet. But then they took the carpet out, and then it was a pit of water. And then
Oh no!
Whoa!
But
you need turbo team.
And they go in. The front is going right into the water, yet somehow it's level.
Mm-hmm. And there's babes in there.
Yeah. Exactly. I mean, there's a lot.
I didn't even notice that.
I know, but like, they're like, all right, well, we'll just plan to land on the tarp, like, before they set it up, right? Like, we'll just plan to land on the tarp. What? Let's not check it at all. Let's just land on it.
Get in a fight.
Ask the safety inspector.
Rescue. Right. With all of his might. Bigfoot, when you need him, you know he's
I love that guy.
Bigfoot, he'll crush him and make him leave town.
Bigfoot and the muscle machine.
They're big, bad, dirty, and mean.
They're big, bad, dirty, and mean.
Yeah, so I mean,
we have the whole series on DVD, so we could definitely pick a good episode to watch.
Don't you think 90% of their budget went into like the intro themes and the songs and like paying the background singers to come in to do these songs? Don't you think like that's
digging the hole and filling it with water and then getting the tarp to put over it?
Exactly, filling it with cartoon alone, filling it with cartoon water, and then. Yeah, so I think we should watch a Bigfoot episode this
thumbs
year.
Way up.
All right, last one. Last one I'm going to show you is Little Rosie. And
yes.
But do you know which Rosie this is? Which Rosie do you think this is?
Kaylin, do you know?
Yes, it's Roseanne Barr, okay.
Okay, all right, okay. Because there's another
How
Rosie.
How dare you
there's
misspeak Rosie. On an episode.
Did we ever watch the Rosie O'Donnell one? Because I was confused. When I saw Little Rosie, I thought it could have been Rosie O'Donnell or it could be Roseanne Barr.
I don't know that there ever was a Rosie O'Donnell one.
I think there is a Rosie O'Donnell one.
Well, there's both?
Based on Exit to Eden?
No.
back
Look
to
it
SM.
Up. I'm pretty sure, unless this is like a Berenstain Bears moment, this is a, unless this is Berenstain Bears.
There is a Roseanne Barr cartoon, I think.
Well, this is the Roseanne Barr one that we're about to watch. Rosie O'Donnell.
Oh, the Rosie O'Donnell one. I think the confusion was that her talk show had an animated Rosie.
Yeah, that's what it was. Yep.
Intro.
The intro. So yeah.
Look it up though to confirm, because I feel like there is a Rosie O'Donnell. Anyway, this is Little Rosie, and the theme song is sung by an incredible singer, like a respected musician and like a legend of music. So see if you can figure out who this is.
Hmm.
The world is full of watch-out-fors. Can't do that, and tough, there are no mores.
Spectre, Ronnie Spector?
Yep. Ronnie Spector, Ronnie Spector. Yes, Ronnie Spector sang this, yes. Yeah, Ronnie Spector sang this intro song for a Saturday morning cartoon.
On his point, scale.
Thank you.
She's a clown, but she's no fool. She breaks up Ben's most every rule.
Little Rosie, that's our little Rosie.
She's always got some role to play. She knows she's got to make every day.
A little Rosie, that's our little Rosie.
See, they could have ended it there. Nope. They could have just said, "This is the Little Rosie Show." Yeah.
The one and only. That's our Little Rosie. That's our Little Rosie. Little Rosie.
I mean, she kind of looks like Meatloaf a little bit, doesn't she? Like. It kind of looks
the
like
the animated version.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. And I watched a little bit of it, and it's I don't know. She has a distinctive voice, but they didn't go with her distinctive voice. You know, like Roseanne, I'm Roseanne. You know, like she has the like kind of, but they went with a lower. I don't know. Well, let's watch it. We should watch it.
Yeah, I'd watch it.
Yeah.
Can I show the intro to the Rosie O'Donnell show just to clear it up once and for all?
Oh, please do.
I think she never had a Saturday morning cartoon, but this was the intro to her talk show.
Okay.
Rosie,
could see why in your head.
Oh, Berenstain Bears thing.
Mm-hmm. I think little Rosie.
Wow. Okay.
I do have a night shirt from this show.
Do you really? Wow. Koosh slingshots and everything. Yeah.
I mean, and she did go to my high school, and I did go to a filming of the show. So yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, but
that,
wait.
That was my whole confusion with Rosie and Barr last time, was that I kept saying, anyway, but Rosie O'Donnell did go, yeah, to the same high school as me, and she's a kindred spirit. I know there's a lot of haters out there, but I like Rosie a lot.
Where did you get the night shirt? Was it at the taping?
Eric bought it for me, but it's from the taping. Yeah.
Okay. But did they sell them like at Kmart's and stuff, or was it?
I think
it
they
like
were
a...
like giveaways. They were giveaways, oh, okay, if you went to the show.
And so he must have got it on eBay or something.
Oh yeah. Though I'm sure, okay, I had one when I was a kid I went.
Yeah.
And if it's a nightshirt, I think you should wear it for a little Rosie episode to further confuse.
Yes, I will.
Okay. Mark it on your calendars, everybody.
Hey, I just want to play one bonus at the end of this episode of Little Rosie. I just watched the end credits, and I just love the voiceover guys from when they're telling you what's coming up next, you know, like, so here's that guy. Here we go.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
Comes to visit, but wears out her welcome on Life Goes On. Then, America's Funniest Home Videos shows you how to laugh until you lose control, lose your mind, or lose your balance. After, find your way to an evening full of laughs on America's Funniest People. Now stay tuned for Match Game next.
You see that? Song sung by Ronnie Spector.
There it is, girl.
Yeah.
America's watching.
Okay. Yeah, so there we go. So, and I think Ronnie Spector just died this year.
She did
too.
Just die.
Yeah, just recently. So, RIP. All right, so let's play a little game. Let's see how well you guys listened to the lyrics of the songs. Double Dragon, you ready? I didn't do any graphics. Nick, last week you did you spent like,
I used them all up. I used up all our graphics budget and time. Yeah,
exactly. So now I just have to like read you. I have to read you things. All right, Double Dragon. To be the dragon, you've got to be strong, humble, never.
Dragon.
Yes, all right. Kaylin, 1 point. Ding. All right. Police Academy. They fight for just. Okay, this is the Fat Boys rapping. They fight for justice. They stand up for the truth. They save us from the power of the
Duluth.
They fight for justice. They stand up for the truth. They save us from the power of the. And by the way, I had to listen to this about 80 times before it might not even be right.
But we have to guess what you think it is.
Exactly. So you're guessing what I think
I'll say
it is.
The uncouth.
Oh.
Good. Bad tooth.
They fight for justice, they stand up for the truth, they save us from the power of the cowardly crooks.
No,
I think it is.
How didn't I get that?
Okay. I think I heard cowardly, but I didn't know crooks was in there. Yeah.
Well, there were two crooks running by when they said it, but they were able to like. Okay.
They were cowardly.
My pet monster. All right, and I'm reversing these lyrics here. Okay, so like the second part is going to be read first because I like the first part of the lyrics better. So I'm going to have that be the second part. Exactly. So my pet monster, a monster as a friend, my pet monster, on him I
will depend.
Will depend?
Can depend?
Okay. What's everybody's final answer here?
Can depend.
Okay.
I'll say can depend as well.
Okay. Well, Kaylin said it first. It is can depend. On him I can depend. Yes. All right. How many points does everybody have?
Great this time.
We got the goose egg.
Redeeming my impressions round.
Teddy Ruxpin.
I saw your impressions short.
here's Teddy Ruxpin. come dream with me tonight. Let's go to far off places and search for treasures
that will delight,
that are so bright.
Can you read it once more?
Yep. Come dream with me tonight. Let's go to far off places and search for treasures I mean, this is the way they wrote lyrics for these theme songs.
I'm trying to get the syllables down. It feels like it's something
I know. It'll seem obvious to you once you hear it, but it'll also seem dumb when you hear it. You'll be like, oh, that I get it, but also that's dumb. Come dream with me tonight.
Something about taking flight. That's all I can think of.
I think, Nick, I think you were the closest. Come dream with me tonight. Let's go to far off places and search for treasures bright.
I said delight, but
yeah. I said something bright.
You said bright, George. Okay, so George, you get a half point.
Half point?
Because you tried to make it a sentence. You don't have to make it a sentence. That's the thing. Mm-hmm. Search for treasures.
I was thinking of the Fat Boys version of the Teddy Ruxpin theme song.
Okay.
Do that again.
Do it one more time, Nick.
Come dream with me tonight. Watch the birds as they fly by.
All right, here's Elf. Nick, you're gonna like knock this one out of the park. This is just you ready? If you don't get this one, it's gonna be so embarrassing.
Nick, just sing the whole
can
right
of corn.
Now.
Let me knock it out of the park.
Okay. These are the cats singing. Mm-hmm. Gordon sent us into outer space because there ain't no one like you in the
Melmacian race.
Yep, exactly. Yep, you got it right.
Or unless it was episode one, the Melmacian race.
No. I wanted this one. I wanted the correct one for this one. Bigfoot, when you need him, you know he's around. Bigfoot, he'll crush them and make them
leave town.
George,
sink Galen. Into a hole in the under a,
in the
under
ground
a tarp.
Under the tarp.
Put them in the ground, like he's
leave town. Nick, you got it. He'll crush
I
them.
I remember
and make
that
them...
one.
I mean, the logistics of that though. He'll crush them and then make them leave town.
They kind of have
to. Yeah.
Mosey out in a crushed form.
All right, little Rosie, we're in the home stretch here. She's always got some role to play. She knows she's got to make every day a
Melmacian race.
I think this is actually a clever lyric. Listen, she's always got some role to play. She knows she's got to make every day a She's always got some role to play. She knows she's got to make it every day. What's the show called?
Rosie.
A Rosie Day?
What's the show called?
Rosie?
A Little Rosie Day?
Yes, A Little Rosie. A Little Rosie. She's got to make every day A Little Rosie.
Got it. Yeah. Okay.
Caitlin, you don't seem like you're impressed by that. I'd like that lyric.
Sorry.
She's always. Got well,
I mean,
some
it's hard to. We were using rhymes to try to figure these out, and there's nothing going on.
I gotta change it up. It's a game show. I gotta change it up. Yeah. All right, last one, and then we're done with this whole thing. All right, this is for America's Funniest People. Remember when he was talking about America's Funniest People at the end?
Of course.
During the voiceover guy suggests that you, the viewer, find your way to an evening full of
laughs.
Yep, Nick got it. All right.
3 points. I won.
Did you win?
Galen too. George with a half point. Yeah.
Mm. Oh, wow.
I wasn't keeping track.
Nick was the only one keeping track, but
the scorekeeper wins.
All right. So I guess we learned a little bit, but I think George, you probably learned the most, right? You always do.
No, I definitely learned something here. All of these intros remind us that episodes of Saturday morning cartoons are extraordinarily representative of the entire human experience. The opening credits are our childhood. It's inviting, it's colorful, the main characters are introduced, the music is catchy, and there's promise of great things ahead. The first segment, our early adulthood, is often engaging, but it feels like a little less effort and money is being put into it. Still, we're paying attention. Maybe things will improve. By the second commercial break, middle age, we're either entranced or just waiting for it all to wrap up. Finally, the closing credits are our period of reflection and regret before a merciful fade to black. Yet, like each Saturday morning, we are reincarnated moments later with a whole new cartoon introduction, filling us with new hope. So never give up if you're unsatisfied with your circumstances today. Just remember, if you wait long enough, you'll find yourself reborn as a talking dog or cute alien or some other bullshit toy tie-in. And that's why I always say, the more you battle is twice the knowing.
I'm going to say that's your best dark. One ever. Yeah. No, that's his best one ever.
No, it was beautiful. I thought.
No,
inspiring.
I was looking back at my life during that one. Like I was
Joe's deathbed visions.
It was Joe's deathbed visions all over again. Yes. Wow. That was I'm going to rewatch that one a few times.
I thought about life. I thought about the human race. I thought about the Elmashian race. all during that lesson at the end. Well done.
All right. You guys, that's it. That's all I got. What do you guys want to watch? Do you guys want to, which one stuck out the most, would you say? Oh, yeah. George.
I want to watch Madballs.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. It's fun for y'all.
Yeah. I'm highlighting it. Madballs definitely on there.
Rosie for sure.
Rosie.
Bigfoot. Oh, Bigfoot
for
is,
sure.
It's okay. I've got Alf animated series on deck as well. Whether
okay.
You want to or not.
Let us know in the comments which one spoke to you. Rockspin? I mean, what maybe? No.
George, it looks like ass.
You had one. That
no, I just I want to do a Kickstarter that where Bigfoot meets Turbo Teen because there was something about Bigfoot and the what was it, the Dark Rider or the giant monster truck that came after him.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
gotta wrap
all
this up.
I know, but like, but here's the thing: the fact that Caitlin hated Teddy Ruxpin so much makes me want to watch it even more because that's gonna be so much more fun if you hate it while you're watching it. No, that's not how it works.
No. Okay. So ineptitude is funny.
The person volunteering her time to be on the show doesn't want to watch something she doesn't have to. Yeah.
Oh boy, but that's way more entertaining. Anyway,
well, for Joe, myself, Caitlin, and Grundo, happy Shaturday, everybody.
Happy Shaturday!